بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد with the blessing of Allah سبحانه وتعالى we are still in the same book of the 40 hadith النووي that were brought together by Imam النووي we are on a hadith number 3 today about the 5 pillars of Islam The five pillars of Islam. Inshallah, we'll read in Arabic and then explain it in English and then see the benefits and try to just explain it a bit more, inshallah, what we benefit from this great hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. An Abi Abdirrahman. It is on the authority of Abi Abdirrahman. Abdullah ibn Umar, the son of Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab, قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول, he said that I heard the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول, I heard the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was saying, بني الإسلام على خمس. Islam has been built on five pillars. The first pillar being Shahadati Alla ilaha illallah, testifying that there is no God but Allah. Wa anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, and that is the messenger, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah. Wa iqami salah, performing the prayers. وَإِيْتَاءِ الزَّكَاةِ, paying the zakat. وَحَجِّ الْبَيْتِ, making the pilgrimage to the house. وَصَوْمِ رَمَضَانِ, and fasting the month of Ramadan. The hadith is related by Bukhari and Muslim. Inshallah, now we will go into explaining the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Let's just, inshallah, so that we can understand these sahabas little bit, the person who narrated the hadith, so that we understand little bit about them and explain little bit about them, and then we'll go slightly deeper into the hadith and understanding the meanings of it. So at the beginning, I'll be reciting it in Arabic, the way I've done it, and then explain it in English, and then go deeper into explaining it, inshallah, a little bit, so that it can be beneficial for all of us. Abdullah ibn Umar is the one who narrated this hadith. His name is Abdullah ibn Umar ibn al-Khattab ibn Nufail al-Qurayshi. He is the son of the second Khalifa of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab, and he is from the tribe of Quraysh. He, Abdullah ibn Umar, joined Islam at a very young age before he reached the age of puberty, along with his father Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, and he is amongst the Sahabas who migrated from Mecca to Medina with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. At the time of his migration, Sayyidina Abdurrahman ibn Abdullah ibn Umar, he was only 10 years old. When the battle of Islam, because he was about 10, about to reach 11. When the battle of Badr taken place, he, at a very young age, he wanted to join. He was told to go home. And then after that, the second battle of Islam, battle of Uhud, also is done the same. But he was told that he is still young. Look at how young men at the time who wanted to help the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and defend Muslims at that time. And at the battle of Khandaq, he was 15 years old. That is when he was allowed to join the battle in defending the Muslims when they were coming under attack in Medina. Now, he was known to be one of the great Sahabas of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who is knowledgeable and also who has turned his back on this dunya. He was not interested in this dunya, and he was one of the Sahabas who was known to be very much following the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam step by step, very much so. And also he was one of the big scholars of this deen, and he is one of those great Sahabas of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam who narrated quite a lot of the hadiths. The hadith that were narrated by Abdullah ibn Umar, it reached 1630 hadith. May Allah bless him. There's so many things with those. It is this hadith that we're reciting today. It is narrated by him, and he died in the year 72 or year 73 of Islamic calendar year, and he lived for 87 years before he died. He was quite an old man. May Allah bless him and bless his soul. So the hadith itself is Buniyal Islam. The Islam itself, it was built. It is an example of a building that was built ala khamsin, using five pillars. The five pillars, meaning that any one of these pillars was to be removed, it collapses. Therefore, your Islam will not be complete if any one of these was to be missing. Shahadatu an la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. Shahada is to testify, saying it with your tongue and your heart to agree what you're saying, and your actions to follow what you're saying, and testifying that there's no one worthy of worship who can do each and everything other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one, anyone else, whatever they do, it must be with the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala selected him because he had so many good qualities. He never lied in his life. He was so honest. He was so trustworthy, and he's never disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So majority of his life, almost all of his life, all of it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided him to be the best human being to ever lived in this life, and beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Habibur Rahman. And also, wa iqami salah, praying at his prescribed time, praying when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to pray. We are the slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this world. We must do as we are told, because a slave does what his masters want. We are told what to eat and what not to eat. We are told when to pray, the time to pray, who we can marry, what we can do, who can we not marry, when to go to the masjid. Everything, our life is planned. We are following what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want us to follow, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make these rules for us to have a beautiful life in here and the hereafter. Those who follow will be successful in here and the hereafter, and those who turn their back, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will destroy them in here, will give them a very difficult life in here, and also after here they'll have such a difficult time. Wa ita'i zakat, giving in charity. Islam is a deen of caring, deen of love. We have to love one another. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, all Muslims are brothers. Everywhere they are, you must feel that he is your brother. And he said, وَكُونُوا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ إِخْوَانًا, be brothers. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةً, Muslims, the believers are brothers. Wherever they are, therefore Islam cares a lot about this brotherhood, and also giving zakat for those who are well off, to give to those who are less well off, those who are poor, those who are in need. And zakat is a must. It is a fard. It is not something that you're giving or you're doing a favor. If you don't do it, if you don't give it to those who are well off, to those who are less well off, those who are in need and poor, you will get punished by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is severe punishment by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for those people who do not pay zakat. وَحَجِّ الْبَيْتِ And going to Hajj once in a lifetime, it is a must. And then after that, it is a sunnah. So you can do it as many times you want. After that, the first one, it is a must, a fard, a compulsory. If you have means and you do not go, the Prophet ﷺ said, if that person wants to die as a Jew or as a Christian, because his Islam is not completed. If you had means, what does it mean having means? If you have the tickets to go, the tickets coming back, and the money to spend there, and the money while you are there, your family to have money to spend, therefore, and you, and the way to be, the way of going to be safe, and that you are not sick, you are not ill, therefore you must go. If you do not go, you have not completed one of the major pillars of Islam, and you will be asked by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But unfortunately today, people have money, they are going on holiday, first holiday, second holiday, third holiday. What are you going to say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when He asks you, have you performed the action of Hajj? You will only know what to answer, because you will be asked by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you the means and you've refused to go. وَصَوْمِ رَمَضَانِ Fasting the month of Ramadan. It is only 1 month in a year, and we must fast as a Muslim. It is not an option. Only those who cannot, or those who are traveling, or those who are weak, or those who are very old and cannot do it. Therefore, there's other things that they can do. And those who are traveling, they'll have to make up when they come back. Or those who are sick, when they get better, they have to make up. And inshallah, after the continuation of this book, we'll explain bit by bit of these parts, inshallah. And Islam, the way we said, the pillars of deen, it is of three parts. And also, we have the iman, and that will follow, inshallah, with these in other books, and the ihsan. The Islam, arkanul Islam, these pillars of Islam are what are done by the body. Shahadat Allah ilaha illallah, you have to say it performed by the body itself. So the in Islam, there are things that are performed by the body. There are things that you perform using your wealth. There are things that are performed using your heart. So the iman and the belief is within your heart. It's not something that you do believing in the angels. You don't do an action to believe. So it is inside your heart. You, no one can look at your heart and take an x-ray and find out whether you believe in the angels or not, believing the Day of Judgment. All these are what you believe in your heart. But these are arkanul Islam, the five pillars of Islam. It is what you performed using your body. For example, pronouncing and acting upon La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. Performing your salat, you have to go down, bow down, ruku', sujood, stand up and recite and all this. Giving zakat, you have to give it using your wealth, using your hands. And going to Hajj, it's an action that you have to perform. Difficulties are involved. Fasting the month of Ramadan, you have to use the body to fast the month of Ramadan. So, what are the benefits that we can benefit from this hadith? We have, amongst the benefit is understanding that this deen is built using these five pillars. If any one of these pillars is missing, you are not full Muslim, or you are not a Muslim. If you deny any one of these and say, no, salat doesn't exist, then you are not Muslim. If you do not perform it, you will get sins, and your Islam is not complete. And also, the act of worship also can be differentiated into three parts in Islam. There is those that perform using your wealth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to test you using your wealth. And also He want to test you using your body. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He want to test you using your heart. So giving charity, giving sadaqah, it is the ibadah, or it is an act of worship. You're using your wealth, because we are in a test in this life, in a very short life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is testing us, and following the pillars of Islam, it is using our body, and also believing, being a believer, arkanul iman, these are using your heart to believe. What we could benefit from this hadith, it is showing us that we have to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala using our wealth, using our strength, using everything, our heart, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then what we could benefit, that these two shahadas are asasun, these are the main pillars of Islam. If you do not testify of La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah, you are not a Muslim. Nothing will be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nor any deed will be accepted if you do not perform, if you do not testify and agree with La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. And also, what we could benefit from this hadith, that salat is amongst the major pillars of Islam. Immediately after the La ilaha illallah, a person has to pray. If you once you join Islam, whether you know how to pray or you do not know how to pray, you have to start praying and start learning gradually, because the prayer, it is a connection between the slave and the master, between al-abd wa rabbi, between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In all your difficulties, in all your problems, you submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you bow down to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to solve all your problems, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will do inshaAllah. Dear brothers and sisters, salat, iqam salat, praying at his prescribed time when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted. Salat, the Prophet said, is what differentiates between a Muslim and non-Muslim. Salat is the key to Jannah. Salat is something that the Prophet ﷺ has told us, even at the time when he's about to depart this world. And the Sahabas, they said, nothing do we see a person leaving it, being close to kufr, than salat, leaving salat unnecessarily. It was amongst the major sins that will get punished in the grave. And after that, a person who does not care about the salat. And the ulama, they said, أن من ترك شيئا من أركان الإسلام الخمس عمدا أنه كافر. If you leave any one of the five pillars and you do it, and you leave it on purpose, knowingly, and you leave it on purpose, he said, therefore, that person is counted as a kafir. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. Also, in a hadith that is explaining this great hadith of Abdullah ibn Umar, it was narrated also by Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhu, and he said, الدِّينُ خَمْسٌ. Deen is composed or is made of five things. لَا يَقْبَلُ اللَّهُ مِنْهُنَّ شَيْئًا دُونَ شَيْئٍ. Allah will not accept one without the other. He said, shahadatu an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammad Rasulullah. To testify that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one worthy of worship, and wa anna Muhammad Rasulullah. Wa imanun billahi. You must also believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa malaikatihi, to believe in the angels. Wa kutubihi, in the books of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa rusulihi, in the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa bil jannati, to believe in Jannah. والنار, to believe in the hellfire. والحياة بعد الموت, to believe that there is life after death. هذه واحدة, this is the first one. The second one, صلاة الخمس, the five صلات عمود الدين. The five prayers are the pillars of deen. لا يقبل الله الإيمان إلا بالصلاة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept your iman except when you pray. He said, was zakat, paying charity, tahurun min adh-dhunubi, it cleans you from your sins. Wala yaqbalu Allahu al-imana, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept believing. Wala salata, also praying, illa bizakat, ill except when you agree to pay the charity salat, otherwise the zakat, otherwise your salat will not be accepted, your iman you will not be accepted. He said, faman fa'ala al-arba'a, ha'ula'i al-arba'a, thumma ja'a ramadan, and then when ramadan comes, fataraka siyamahu muta'ammidan, and he was to leave fasting, and he did it on purpose. لم يقبل الله منه, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept of him الإيمان ولا الصلاة ولا الزكاة. He will not accept your iman, he will not accept your salat, he will not accept your zakat. فمن فعل هؤلاء الأربع ثم تيسر له الحج, and then whoever was to do those, and then Hajj was easy, he had the means to go. فلم يحج, he was not to go to Hajj, ولم يوصي بحجته, you did not tell people to perform Hajj for him, if he was to die, and then his family members were not to perform for him. لم يقبل الله منه الأربعة, Allah will not accept the iman, the salat, the fasting, and the zakat, and the Hajj, and the shahada. They will not be accepted if you have done it on purpose and you've left it. So brothers, these are very important things, inshallah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us. These are the pillars of deen. This is what the deen is made of. We should hold into each one of them, understand it, and then act upon it, and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy for us. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.